Welcome guys. So today we are going to derive an important expression using entropy conservation. Now this is G star S which we looked at in the last video. This is the expression for entropy density. And if this is the expression for entropy density, I can write total entropy S times volume, because this is entropy density. So this will become 2 pi square over 45 G star S volume. Volume will be, I can write A cube, co-moving volume T cube. And this VC is co-moving volume, co-moving volume. So total entropy is equal to two pi square 45 co-moving volume G star S A cube T cube. And total, using entropy conservation, if we use entropy conservation, we will see that S is equal to constant implies gives us G star S A cube T cube equal to constant. So this put this expression in your toolbox. It's a very important expression. We will be using it to derive many important expressions of the early universe. And especially this will be helpful to us in neutrino decoupling, if I have to give you heads up. And we'll study neutrino decoupling later in one of our next lectures. And this is a very handy expression that we will be using there. Now, if you see that AT that A cube T cube AT proportional to G star S to the power minus 1/3. So is AT constant? AT is constant as long as G star S is constant. So if G star S is not constant, AT will not be constant. And we have seen that G star S is this, given by this. Is G star S constant? Is this AT equal to constant? You have seen, you must have seen this in earlier basic cosmology courses, that AT is equal to constant. But AT actually it is not AT equal to constant. Actually it is this expression which is equal to constant. But let's see why this expression is approximated to AT equal to constant. AT equal to constant, not always. So AT is equal to constant, not always. This is equal to constant, always. This is always. And this is not always. But still, you know, we use this a lot. And why we use this a lot instead of using this? Because in the scenario when all the species are at same temperature, and based upon our current understanding of the universe, based upon the current understanding of the universe, this term Ti over T whole cube is mainly used, mainly it comes into a picture when the thermal mixture gets, this is one thermal mixture gets divided into, one thermal mixture gets divided into two thermal mixtures. So thermal mixture 1 and thermal mixture 2. And when does this happen? This happens at the time of neutrino decoupling, which we will study later. So one thermal mixture gets divided into two thermal mixtures, two relativistic. This is also relativistic, because if it is non-relativistic, then we don't worry about it, because this here we take into account the contribution that comes from the relativistic particles. If it is non-relativistic particle, we don't bother. We just don't take that particle's contribution into account. But Ti over T separate temperature scenario does not happen when a particle simply drops out because it becomes non-relativistic. Here what happens is that when neutrino decouples, neutrino is relativistic. So at this point, shortly before, we have photon, electron, positron, neutrinos and antineutrinos. After, we have photon, electron, positron, and we have, seems running out of ink here. Let's try this one. Neutrinos and antineutrinos. Yeah, so, and this is also relativistic, this is also relativistic, and now because we have this scenario where we have more than one relativistic mixtures, we need this expression with Ti over T. But if in the scenario when we have one relativistic picture, and for example when we have to study, let's say this is point A, point B, point C and point D. If we have to study the universe from point A to just before point B up to here, then we can employ, then everything is at same temperature T, then we have G star S is equal to G I alpha I. And because everything is at, every species is at same temperature T, Ti over T whole cube will not come. So this, and when we have to study from here to here, for this particular mixture, again, we can employ this thing. For this, again, we can employ this anyway, this, there is only one species here, neutrino, antineutrino. So this may not be relevant here, although you can use it, but you won't get anything out of it because we have only one species. And here we are dealing with more than one species. We have photons and this electron positron pair, and we can use this picture here from B to C. But when you are going from A to C, you must take into account this branching here. From going from A to C or from A to D, or let's say that now when I say this, you have to be very careful here. When I say that you are going from A to C, right? And so C means that you are looking at some temperature T today. This is today. And this is Big Bang. So from Big Bang to today, when you are coming, From Big Bang to today, when you are coming, you must take into account this branching, and that is why this expression is helpful. But from Big Bang to any point just before B, there is no decoupling happening there. So you don't have to, you always have one uniform mixture, and the only in that mixture, the only thing which is changing is the number of relativistic species. And when you go from B onwards to C, again the in that thermal mixture, which is a photon thermal mixture, if we put from B to C, this is a photon thermal mixture and this is a neutrino thermal mixture. Going from B to C in the photon thermal mixture, again, except for this electron positron annihilation, in the trajectory of time trajectory of the photon path, only thing that changes is when this electron positron becomes non-relativistic. Other than that, photon is always other than that, G star S will be G of photon. But only you have to take into account this expression G I alpha I for the photon, electron and positron pair before it decouples, and then after it decouples there will be before electron annihilates there will be a different value, after electron annihilates there will be a different value. So this AT is equal to constant is a very you can say it is an approximation to this G star S A cube T cube constant, but it is a good approximation. The reason is that this AB point is A to B is a very short period of time, and then B to C is a very long period of time. This A to B is a very short period of time. So during this time AT equal to constant. I will come back to that. From B to that point when electron and positron annihilate, which means electron becomes non-relativistic, this becomes non-relativistic, and then we only have photon, and from here onwards it's always AT is equal to constant. So AT is equal to constant after annihilation to present. AT is also equal to constant when the thermal mixture is at one temperature T and G star S, which is Gi alpha I, G star S, which is Gi alpha I, when the thermal mixture is at one temperature T, and in between two thresholds, threshold by threshold we mean, let me illustrate this. So we have G star S A cube T cube equal to constant. Now let me mention one important point of mass threshold. Mass threshold. Now mass threshold is the temperature when above which the species is relativistic and below which the species is non-relativistic. So for example, for electron the mass is 0.5, I think it's 0.511 approximately mega electron volts. So above this temperature, the particle is relativistic. I mean, there is some margin there, that when temperature is much higher than this mass of the species, then the particle is relativistic, and when it is much lower, then the particle is non-relativistic. So we will say that mass of particle is basically the mass threshold. Mass threshold is a temperature below which it will be non-relativistic, and above which it will be relativistic, roughly speaking. Now what happens is that say we have a thermal mixture, one thermal mixture, and in this thermal mixture we are having particles A, B, C and D. Now at this point D becomes non-relativistic during this time. D starts becoming non-relativistic, and then finally it becomes non-relativistic. This is the time during which D becomes non-relativistic. D becomes non-relativistic. Non-relativistic. And after this, we are left with A, B, and C. So we are left with A, B, and C. And here we have A, B, C, D. And this is the intermediate scenario when D is not fully non-relativistic, but it is semi-relativistic, and from relativistic, semi-relativistic to completely non-relativistic is this period. Now here we have, and again they are all at same temperature T. Here also at any given point the temperature is same. Here also at any given point the temperature is same. So when you are looking at this particular scenario, in which a particle comes out of the thermal mixture because it is becoming non-relativistic. That scenario of neutrino coming out of thermal mixture is a special scenario of decoupling. So I am not talking about that scenario. I am saying we have a one thermal mixture, and from that thermal mixture we have a group of particles in that thermal mixture, and one particle becomes non-relativistic. I am talking of that scenario. So from one thermal mixture a particle becomes non-relativistic. And when that particle becomes non-relativistic, what happens to G star S? So here G star S is, G star S is contribution from, basically G star S is basically contribution from, G I alpha I for ABCD. ABCD, and here we have G I alpha I for ABC. So let us say that that non-relativistic scenario, or let me build this further here. So we have ABCD, they all were present here for a good period of time. For a good period of time, G star S was constant. G star S was constant for a good period of time. Then for a small period of time, G star S reduced from this value to this value, and then again it became constant for a good period of time. Then again for a small period of time, let us say now C starts becoming non-relativistic, and now we are left with A and B after this. Now we have A and B. A and B here. So now it comes from A B. So we had G I alpha I sum over ABCD for a good period of time. For a brief period of time, that when D becomes non-relativistic, then it begins to decrease, and finally it stabilizes at gi alpha I abc. It stabilizes to a value for a good period of time, then again for that brief period of time it decays, it decreases from this value to this value, the value of ab, and after that again it is constant for a good period of time, and then again it becomes after that, when we are left with the ab again, you know, that decay of b happens, I mean b becomes non-relativistic. So when b becomes non-relativistic, we are left with a, and a again, when we are left with a, we get g a alpha a, and this is constant till present, which is basically photon. So we are finally left with photon. And of course there is another branch of neutrino also somewhere here, but that neutrino is decoupled and following its own thermal history after decoupling. So after decoupling, neutrino following its own separate thermal history, and we are mainly focusing upon the photon line here. So photon line, so basically this stays constant, and even before neutrino decoupling, or even after neutrino decoupling, when we shift our focus to the photon thermal mixture, notice that for a good period of time, all the particles are having same temperature, and for a brief period of time, when one particle switches from relativistic to non-relativistic, it during that time G star S value decreases, and then it again stabilizes. So here this is a value of G star S, and then it decreases, and then it stabilizes to this value, and like this is one, we have ABCD, D becomes non-relativistic, now we have G star S contribution from ABC. Now C becomes non-relativistic, we have G star S contribution from AB. B becomes non-relativistic, we have G star S contribution from A, which is basically photon. So we are left with photon, and then photon is like in our universe right from Big Bang to the present. So when G star S is constant, we have derived an expression that G star S A cube T cube is constant, and we just through arguments, most of these are verbal hand wavy arguments, but I have explained that G star S is constant in the majority of the thermal history of the universe. Like it's constant in almost you can say based upon our current understanding, more than 99% of the history of the universe, 99.99% of the history of the universe, it is constant. Only if there are brief moments when G star S starts changing, and during those moments you have to use this expression. This is true expression. And when you take G star S to be constant, then you can get rid of that first G star S term, and then you get A cube T cube equal to constant, which is AT equal to constant. So that AT is equal to constant is a good approximation of this expression, which is more accurate. Now I am saying more accurate, I am not saying it is the accurate expression, because I mean we don't know what other things were in the, what happened in the universe at that time, and what other principles which we don't know today happened are there in our universe. We don't know the complete story of the universe, but based upon our understanding, and I can say that this is based upon our understanding, this is what we know: G star S A cube T cube constant from the entropy conservation. And when you take G star S to be constant, which is which it was during most of the history of the universe, you can say 99.9999% history of the universe, it was constant, then we can take AT is equal to constant. Thank you.